The most relaxing way that I have found to apply skincare, and yes, this uses magnetic misting technology. Is it worth the hype? That's what we're here to discuss. This is the réduit, which translates to reduce. And although I've had this for about 3 months, I actually started incorporating this daily into my routine through my 28-day skincare challenge. As you know, skincare doesn't work if you don't use it. And although this is a luxury device, I decided to put it to the test. In aesthetics, we use facial misting devices. We use steamers, right? And unfortunately, that can actually dry some people out. Steamers aren't always good for your skin. This actually gives quite a similar sensation, but without the excessive heat that steamers do. And I must say that outside of like an aesthetic or professional location, this is probably the best thing I've found. And you might note that I actually have my curly hair today. And that's because yes, this is a skin device, but it also has a hair care component. And we can talk about in the future, but I have been trying to embrace my curls and trying to hydrate and revitalize them with these. These facial magnetic misters are quite new to the market. This one, the réduit, was actually made by the former CEO of Foreo, and this took 20 years of technology to create. And again, réduit means to reduce, and the entire thing about this line is to be more sustainable, to use less. Even the ingredients are very minimal. They claim that they have like 50% less ingredients than most other skincare products do, and that because you're not applying products to your hands, you're just misting them directly onto and into the face. They're supposed to penetrate better, and they're supposed to give you better coverage with less waste overall. And there are very few facial misters out there. As you know, I've actually tried other ones as well. I've done comparisons. And when they actually saw the other content we produced, they said, hello, would you like to work with us on a video? And I said, yes, please. So this video is in partnership with réduit. But we're gonna talk about that a little bit later, because first off, how exactly does this work? I feel like this is a more sustainable version of a Keurig. You know, the little Keurigs, how you have these little cups of coffee and you put them inside of the little coffee machine. That's kind of like what this is, only they have these skin pods and hair pods, but for today, skin pods. And you actually pop them into these little devices and you twist. Now, it's that easy, and as long as the device is charged, you just press this button on the side or on the back, and all of a sudden, it starts misting. Listen to that. Isn't that beautiful? This is extraordinarily relaxing. And again, I would say this is the closest thing to a steamer without actually having a steamer, but it doesn't irritate your face the way steam can. They do have a patented technology for this. And when I first saw these pods, I was like, is this just like those coffee ones that like become wasteful and destroy our environment? But actually no. réduit actually has a send back program where if you send these back, not only are they able to reuse and recycle them, but they actually give you a free one when you do turn these in. This is actually really interesting. It's kind of like a reservoir inside of here. And then under this little tiny lid here, you have this piece of technology, which is what actually uses ultrasonic diffusion and magnetic misting technology to micronize and infuse this into the skin. Each one of the little pods, whether it's skin or hair, is set up just like this. And again, you kind of just pop them into these devices. This is the Skin Spa one. I absolutely love this. It is very luxurious, but they do also have this Uni, which is more of like a travel or mini one. And I must say, it actually works comparably well, just with different settings. They do have these different little skin pods, and you can actually choose the ones that are right for your skin. And again, they also have some for hair. For skin, the ones that I've been using are the Clear Dew Skin Pod, the Pearl Diffusion Skin Pod, and the Precision Shield Skin Pod. And what's shocking to me is that not only do these have great ingredients and 50% less ingredients than a lot of other skincare products have, but they actually don't have fragrance either. And that was really nice for me to see, because I feel like whenever we have like a luxury product, all of these brands just shove fragrance into it. It's like, well, what about people who want a luxury experience, or they want a nice relaxing experience, but they don't want the fragrance, or they don't want the essential oils or things like that? And I feel that for people who actually want their skincare to work with good ingredients and with cutting edge technology, this is actually something that surprised me in ways that I wasn't expecting. Some of these skin pods have ingredients like niacinamide, like tranexamic acid, like allantoin and green tea. But the whole thing about each one of them is that you can use them alone or you can layer them, but they don't feel like they're leaving residue on your skin. They're actually made to be extraordinarily absorbable by the skin, and the company actually claims that 100% of the ingredients do get penetrated into it because of the way it's misted. You see, with a lot of skincare products, they do sit on the outside of the skin, and for a sunscreen or for an occlusive moisturizer, that's fine, but when we actually want stuff to penetrate, it has to get through the barrier of our skin. Remember, our skin is our body's largest organ, and its job is to literally keep things out. So to get things into the skin, we have to make sure that they are very small or micronized so that they are propelled in a certain certain way to actually get into the skin where they can do their best work. They say that their patented technology uses ultrasonic diffusion and magnetic fields to deliver ingredients into the skin and to make it more bioavailable, meaning available for our skin to absorb. The way these little vibrations work in these little pods actually makes this mist super, super fine. And when it goes on the skin, it's also very lightweight. I don't feel like there's anything weighing down or sagging down on my skin. Now, as mentioned, I've been using this morning and evening for my personal 28-day skincare challenge. I do find in the evening that I like a thick balm or like a creamy moisturizer. And yes, I have oily prone skin, but I do like that at night. And so I really use this in a toner essence serum step, kind of as a treatment before I put that thick occlusive on. But for every single day, this is lightweight, it's absorbable, and it's literally the perfect base if you want to go either underneath sunscreen or even underneath makeup. And often, a lot of times niacinamide serums tend to gum up on the skin. If you apply too much, they can get chalky or they can get gummy. This has a lot of niacinamide in it, and no matter how much of this I've used, even if I've done like a double spray, it doesn't gum up on the skin and it doesn't make my skin feel, you know, like I'm being suffocated by a thick layer of something that I have just applied. It's lightweight and it doesn't feel overbearing. And speaking of application, let's speak about how to do that. Once you take that skin pod out, it does have this little lid, and you just want to make sure that you take this off and that exposes this little piece of magnetic technology, which is how it actually forms this really fine micronized mist. You then take this and you put it into this device. Again, you can use the spa one or the uni one, and you just snap right. My uni one snaps really well. Initially, when I was using this, I was having a hard time snapping this one into the skin spa, but once I kind of got the hang of it, I got it to work. And then you just press this little button on the bottom and it starts to spray out. Now, the other thing that makes this different from many of the other skin misters that I've seen is that the other skin misters are one time, one use. You put it in, you have one use. Their whole thing is that you can use these multiple times. You can switch these out. You can use all three if you wanted to give yourself three layers. If you wanted to go from skincare to hair care or hair care to skincare, it's as easy as switching these out, just the way you would if you were choosing a different cup or flavor of coffee in the morning. So you click it into place, you press the start button, and you do want to glide this over the skin. The thing I like about this is that even though it's a fine micronized mist, you can actually feel where it is and you can feel where it's going. If you've ever had a professional facial, you know that feeling of those steam misters. And this is like a non-scalding version of that, but that's actually got ingredients that are penetrating into the skin instead of just steam. In aesthetics, steamers are kind of known as an esthetician's best friend because it helps to quote unquote open up the pores and make the skin supple and ready to take ingredients in. But the problem is that steam can actually dry out the skin and it can lead to transepidermal water loss. And a lot of estheticians don't know that because they're just not taught that. The reason our skin doesn't have a ton of water on it all the time and the reason we even create oil is to make our skin waterproof. And sometimes facial steamers can kind of degrade that skin barrier. Now, what's cool about this is that it's not steaming hot steam. It is literally a nice cooling morning mist. And on top of that, the ingredients inside of here are actually skin supportive. So the ingredients alone help to fight against transepidermal water loss because this infuses both hydration and moisture into the skin. Also, fun fact for my sensitive skin sisters, this actually doesn't have hyaluronic acid either. So for people who are really sensitive to hyaluronic acid, certain skin pods come without them because hyaluronic acid is in pretty much everything and it is very good for some, but others have reactions to it. So the fact that they have fragrance-free skin pods as well as hyaluronic acid-free skin pods really helps for those who are sensitive to a lot of those little ingredients. So you glide this over the skin, and when you're done, you just wait 15 seconds before applying the next one. You can pop the next one right in and go over with a different layer. I sometimes use mine as a one-off and sometimes in three consecutive steps when I do. This is the first one. This is the Pearl Diffusion. And again, what's amazing is that not only is it fragrance-free and essential oil-free, but it only has 12 ingredients. This one is perfect for people who have dark spots and who have blemishes. This actually has ingredients that help. This one does have niacinamide, and this is probably the smoothest niacinamide formula that I've ever applied to my skin. It doesn't gum up at all. And as we know, niacinamide helps to regulate oil production. Because of that, it can help minimize the appearance of large pores. On top of that, it helps create ceramides naturally in our skin, and niacinamide stops our skin cells from sharing their pigment with other skin cells. So if you are prone to things like hyperpigmentation or post-inflammatory breakouts, this is really excellent as like a toner slash essence step to spray on. You can kind of even hold it over one of those areas a little bit longer to give that some extra attention. Tranexamic acid is also amazing for pigmentation, and it doesn't have any vitamin C. So again, for those who are really, really sensitive, it is gentle, but they claim that it penetrates much deeper and that more of those actives are delivered into the skin. So it makes sense to me that they're still using potent active ingredients, but less of these vitamin C's or things like hyaluronic acid that can irritate some people's skin. The Clear Dew is another amazing one. You can use this as a second one, and this one is fantastic for redness. If you struggle with blemishes and really redness and irritation, irritation in skin, this one is a go-to. And again, essential oil-free and fragrance-free. We don't hate fragrances, we don't hate essential oils, but for people who are sensitive to them, it's really hard to find products, let alone luxury products, that don't have them in there. Instead, this has only 12 ingredients. It does have golden chamomile extract, which is known to be anti-inflammatory and really supportive to the skin. This is calming and hydrating, and it's also got a form of azelaic acid. We know that azelaic acid is amazing for rosacea, we know that it's amazing for acne, and there aren't a lot of azelaic acid products on the market. The fact that this one has it in there and actually delivers it into the skin, this is an amazing formula. It's really great for redness, for skin support, and even for a couple of scars and minor breakouts and blemishes. And again, you can use this on its own or as a step two. Now, as a step three, the Precision Shield is also one of my favorites. And this right here is one of the most lightweight bases I have ever used before applying sunscreen or makeup. And normally when you are trying to apply products before a sunscreen, if they peel up, it just makes your sunscreen basically come off. And what's amazing is that doesn't do that. This doesn't peel up, it doesn't get all gummy, and my skin is obsessed. This does have green tea, which is an amazing antioxidant that actually works very well and supports skin underneath sunscreen. This also has allantoin, which we know is amazing for skin support and anti-inflammation. And overall, if you're looking for something to boost up underneath your sunscreen or as a base for makeup, this would be my go-to pod when it comes to that recommendation. When you pop this in, you do have to make sure that the little name is facing down. You really gotta snap it into this skin spa one, and then once you do, you just press the button and you go. And I really like that I don't choke on the mist from this one, and then you can actually feel where you've applied so that you can make sure that you get this in all of the right spots. They do claim that you get more delivery from this because, again, you're not putting product on your hands, and I actually feel like my skin is being almost like kissed or tickled in a way, but then it actually feels hydrated and supported after I do use it. Now, for me, I always use this after washing my face. I want to make sure that there's no sunscreen, there's no leftover skincare from the night before, or there's no makeup like sitting on my skin. So I always use this on a clean canvas, and they say that this ultrasonic diffusion actually diffuses this across skin and into skin well. So personally, I would recommend for everyone, make sure that you don't have like a layer of something else on first. And if you wanted to apply another moisturizer like I do before bed, or a sunscreen like during the day, make sure that you're always applying this before that and not afterwards. They say that the little mist particles that this produces are 50 times smaller than regular skincare particles. So that's why it's supposed to have enhanced penetration and absorption. And it's because it's being applied in that misting application. And again, because it's so lightweight, it's not sticky, it doesn't peel up. And even when I apply a moisturizer or a sunscreen over, it doesn't cause that balling that a lot of niacinamide serums do for me, or that just in general, other serums tend to do. I will say that this is extremely relaxing. This is probably the most relaxing tool that I've ever used. And it is the closest and most comparable thing that I can actually use that is not a facial mister or a facial steamer. So what actually happened to me when I started using this? Again, I started using it about 3 months ago. I was kind of comparing it to some other misters, and I did figure out that I like the way this one feels on my skin better. And this is a part of my 28-day skincare challenge where I'm doing it morning and night. If you are doing the 28-day skincare challenge as well, I would love to know how that's going for you, because we do have to isolate our variables to actually see how they're working. Upon the first week, I did notice that this was very relaxing. I think that's the first thing I realized about this. I liked the way it made my skin look and feel, and it was almost a new sensation because my skin doesn't feel suffocated. It doesn't feel like I'm dripping with stuff. There's a light misting, but it's extremely lightweight, and that, along with the lack of irritation, was the first thing that I noticed. By week two, I actually realized that at night I needed less balms. Again, at night, I really like a thick, heavy moisturizer, and although I still use one, I didn't feel like I needed as much of it. I almost felt like this helped me with my oil control and oil balance. Again, it does have niacinamide, so that would make sense. But by about 14 days, I noticed that my skin was actually really appreciating it, and that I had like a healthy glow, but it wasn't this oily sheen that I normally get around like 4 o'clock pretty much every single day. Now, the weather is changing. Is it autumn? Is that why this was happening? I wasn't sure, but that's why I continued using it. But by the end of that first month that I was using it, I recognized that my skin felt supported, didn't feel overly oily, didn't feel greasy. I can't say that my acne scars are gone, because I still have acne scars and I still break out here and there, but I will say that this didn't cause breakouts or irritation. If you've seen some of the live streams that we've done online, you'll notice that I did have irritation with other facial misters or with other products that just have ingredients from like essential oils or plants. And with this, I didn't notice irritation. If anything, I felt like this did kind of balance out my oiliness in my skin. And then I do feel like my other products go on smoother. And I don't think it's because it's changing the way my other products work. I think it's because this doesn't have, you know, that thick consistency that my other products aren't balling up and gumming up on top of my face. And just by virtue of using less product, it's not creating this layer that's just sitting on top of the skin that is allowing, you know, my sunscreen to pill on me. So now that I'm using this day and night as a part of my 28 day skincare challenge, I almost feel like I want to try this with my other sunscreens that normally pill up on me and see if this makes them easier to apply. And maybe those other sunscreens weren't pilling on me. Maybe it was the product I was using underneath them. So when this 28 day skincare challenge is done, that's what I'll be doing as well. Overall, what are my thoughts? Who is this for and how does it work? This is definitely amazing technology. It's something new to the industry. I could see this becoming a regular practice and like a favorite skincare tool to use, but is this something that you should sacrifice a limb, an appendage, or an unborn child for? No. But is it something to consider if you're looking for something that is lightweight, that absorbs well, that infuses technology in a luxurious way? Then yes, this is definitely something for someone who likes facials but tends to feel like their skin is dry after a facial. You will love this. It is called the Redoui Spa, and it actually feels like a spa at home, where I can't say that with a lot of other devices, but this one does. And then if you are looking for something that is more sustainable, these little pods are literally meant to be a part of a buyback program, and you get multiple uses in each pod. So making sure that you actually save them and send them back is key. But seeing is that you actually get a free one for every 4 that you turn in, it's really nice that they are prioritizing sustainability on top of using less ingredients like fragrances that our skin doesn't actually need. If you have sensitive skin and you can't use a lot of other luxury products, I think you're going to love this. If you do have mild hyperpigmentation or redness, or your skin is just getting older because aging is a privilege, then this is amazing. But if you have severe chronic cystic acne, or if you have, you know, a condition like eczema or rosacea, you need to get that treated by a doctor. That is a medical condition and you should get that treated by them. But if you're looking for something, ooh, especially as the holidays are coming up, if you're looking for a good gift, if you're looking for something that is relaxing, if you're looking for something that is an experience but that also has tangible benefits, then this is it. And yes, they also have this mini one, and they also have the hair one, which I don't know, you tell me. I have a hard time embracing my curls, but we've been spraying, we've been trying, and maybe this is something that we can also do as an update. Let me know your thoughts. Make sure that that like button is hit, and always remember to stay hydrated, both topically and orally, as well as reapplying your SPF and being beautiful both inside and out. I love you, beautiful butterflies, and I cannot wait to see you in this next video. Love you guys. Bye.